Hi, Michael Elliott here. Welcome to Between Two Mammoths. I'm out here in the quad today with Assistant Professor of Biology, Marc Edwards. Marc is one of the creators of the STEM Incubator Program, and we're going to talk a little bit about that today. Marc, maybe you could just start by telling me a little bit about what the STEM Incubator Program is and what catalyzed you to move it forward.
It's a STEM research, summer research cohort program, and I think all of those words are meaningful. What it's meant to do is to take students through a process to introduce them to the question of what research is, what researchers do, the kinds of activities we get into, what does it mean to be involved in chemistry research or biology research or statistics. It's meant to take a group of students and produce sort of research-ready sophomores is sort of the tagline that we have in our head when we're thinking about the programming. So we take students through a six-week program. The first week is sort of a professional development boot camp, if you will. How do you talk to professors? How do you walk up to someone and say, hey, I'd like to be in your lab? How do you navigate that, the sort of social capital it takes to take those steps? How do we give students that kind of experience and that kind of confidence, really? It helps us sort of benchmark them as well. And the subsequent 4 weeks are single week research programs where Chris Durr, who co-created the program with me, will take them into the chemistry lab and do some of his actual research with them. He'll have them create polymers, get their hands wet. They put a lab coat on, and that starts the transformation into them really seeing themselves as scientists. It started when Chris Durr and I ran into each other at the Dean's Retreat for new faculty. Mm-hmm. And I think we're both a bit wide-eyed thinking about the prospects of running an undergraduate powered research laboratory and asking ourselves, who's gonna work in our labs? How do we recruit them? How do we teach them? And I think Chris and I both hit on training, which is that intersection between teaching and research, and thinking about the scope and scale of our questions relative to the larger R1 institutions we came from, and trying to refine that. We thought that this place could be a place that delivers world-class research training, development, and preparation. That is how we could really make our mark as researchers, as professors, and I think more broadly as a college. The thing that really turned us into a program, by then, in close to the summer, we had brought in Brittany Bailey in statistics, right, who was really important for helping us think about how to assess this thing, how to build the box of the incubator so that we can actually have a program that can run. And I think by December 2019, it was a thing. We had started recruiting a cohort. Chris, Brittany, and I looked at each other like, are we?
Are we really doing this?
Are we really gonna do this? But I think by then, Chris and I in particular had students in our laboratories. We'd begun recruiting students. We'd seen the effect that it had on them. And we, all three of us, Chris, Brittany, and I, remember the impact that getting into research laboratories and getting around researchers and undergraduates had on us,
yep,
on our trajectories, and ultimately where we ended up. And it has the potential to change how we do things at the college, both for us, for the students, and little that we know, but I think more broadly.
Yeah. You know, one of the things I love about what you're doing is, you know, undergraduate research was such a powerful force in my college experience here, and I know it was for you, where you attended college. I've talked to generations, yeah, of Amherst alumni who've had research experiences, but their paths were almost always happenstance in terms of how they found themselves,
yep,
doing that. And what you're doing is putting structure around,
yep,
that, ensuring that it's accessible to a broad range of students who may not really understand what research is when, mm-hmm, they arrive at Amherst. And then the cohort building, right? There's a lot of research that shows that cohort building is really powerful.
Absolutely. One of the hidden stories of the incubator is it is a real model for faculty-staff collaboration.
Mm.
And it is a testament to what we can do when we work collaboratively to the best of our ability. And I would say the Center of Teaching and Learning, the Loeb Center, Center for Community Engagement, the Writing Center, our academic and teaching and non-teaching staff in our departments, the Dean's Office, Jack Cheney, everyone pulled together when we said we were going to do this. And they were like, you just tell us how, tell us what you need, we'll get it to you. Now that cohort is graduating.
Right, that first cohort is graduating,
yeah,
this year.
Yeah.
What have they told you about what the experience meant to them? And you know, what does it mean to you to see them cross the stage here?
You know, I'm strangely emotional about it. It really crept up on me this year. We have sent that cohort out to do research around the world. We have sent them to laboratories far flung across the United States. They have done thesis research at record numbers. They have engaged in research thoroughly and sampled things. It worked.
It's fabulous.
It worked in exactly the way we thought it worked. It worked in ways that we didn't even imagine. It changed us. And I think watching the students do their theses, watching them make their way through the world, and having them come back to check on us as much as we check on them, I think that part of it, the camaraderie, the community, the family that has sort of been built around the incubator and seeing the changes that it's made in their lives, mostly from the standpoint of giving them the confidence to explore. They learn that they can do difficult things. Mm-hmm. So they get knocked back and then they get back up and they get back to it. And I think if that is what we taught, then I'm extremely pleased.
Well, it's going to be amazing to watch what those students
yes.
do after they leave Amherst.
Absolutely.
And watch how this develops for the years to come. I'm really excited.
Yeah, so are we. Yeah. So are we.
Well, congratulations to you and to Brittany
it.
And to Chris and to everybody who put so much time into it. Thank you for being here on Between Two Mammoths.
I was excited to be here. Thank you.